Good morning, people. Today we are looking at numericals of chapter 1, electric charges and fields, which are based on electric flux and Gauss's law. We did that in the previous lecture. These are all based from standard 12th NCERT textbook. From the unsolved exercises, I'm going to do numericals 19, 20, 15, 16, 17 and 18. And the illustrations, I'm going to do 11 and 12. So let's start. I hope you can bring your textbooks into play, and I'm using my own textbook and you can use your own. Numerical 1.19 states that a point charge Q is 2 microcoulomb, 10 raised to minus 6 coulomb, is at the center of a cube and it has length 9 centimeter. They wish to find out the net flux coming out of the cube. Now we know by Gauss's law, flux phi is sigma q by epsilon 0. Sigma q is the amount of charge. So you can see 2 into 10 raised to minus 6 coulomb is contained upon epsilon 0 is 8.85 into 10 raised to minus 12. And minus 6 plus 12, that's 10 raised to 6. And 2 by 8.85. That's nearly 2 by 9. So 2 by 9 is nearly 1.9 something. So 1.9, let us call it nearly 2 into 10 raised to 5 Newton per coulomb. This is your flux. And number 20. It says a point charge causes a flux of minus 1 into 10 raised to 3. Hey, flux is Newton meter square per coulomb. I'm sorry about that. Newton meter square per coulomb. To pass through a spherical Gaussian surface of radius 10 centimeters. So it's a spherical Gaussian surface. And what do they wish us to do? They would like to find out, first thing, what is, if the radius of the Gaussian surface were doubled, so r dash becomes 2r, then what, how much flux would pass through? Now, by Gauss's law, flux is sigma q by epsilon 0, I'm sorry. It does not depend on the radius. So, as flux does not depend on radius or the area, so the flux, electric flux, remains same. Now we go to part B also, which says what is the value of the point charge. They would like us to find out Q. So by Gauss's law, flux phi is sigma Q by epsilon 0. So sigma Q, I'm sure you will see, is phi into epsilon 0. Now do not forget that flux is negative. If flux is negative, that means the point charge also is negative. So as flux is negative, the point charge is also negative. Thus, sigma q is phi into epsilon 0. We've seen charge is negative. Flux is how much? 1 into 10 raised to 3 in magnitude. And epsilon 0 is 8.85. into 10 raised to minus 12. That becomes 8.85 into 10 raised to minus 9 coulomb. You can call it nearly 9 nano coulomb. But finally, as charge Q is negative, so Q is minus 9 nano coulomb. This is your final answer. Then we go to number 15. Numerical 15 tells us that electric field E bar is 3 into 10 raised to 3 I cap Newton per Coulomb. They want us to find the flux through a square of 10 centimeter sides, which is lying in the YZ plane. First things first, the area of the square, I'm sure you know area A is L square, that's 100 centimeter square. Let's convert it. 100 into 10 raised to minus 4 meter square, that's 10 raised to minus 2 meter square. But electric flux, we know phi is E bar dot A bar. So we will require A bar. Now understand, if square lies in YZ plane, then the area vector lies parallel to X axis. You can work this out for yourself. So supposing the, you know, the, this is the square, then the area vector would be coming towards you. So, or if this is the square, then the area vector would be in this direction, perpendicular to the face. So parallel to the X axis. Thus A bar is 10 raised to minus 2 I cap meter squared. This is an important discovery. Thus, electric flux, phi, everybody knows, is E bar dot A bar. So phi, how much is E bar? 3 into 10 raised to 3 I cap dot area vector 10 raised to minus 2 I cap. I cap dot I cap is 1. I hope you still remember. I cap dot I cap is J cap dot J cap is K cap dot K cap is 1, but I cap dot J cap dot K cap is K cap dot I cap is 0. I hope you remember this. So I cap dot I cap is 1, and 3 into 10 raised to 3 into 10 raised to minus 2, that's 30 Newton meter square per Coulomb. This is your flux. So this is the idea. The second part, there is a second part of this question which says that if the, what would be the flux if the normal to the plane makes an angle 60 degree with the x-axis. So area vector, normal to the plane is the area vector. Area vector makes angle 60 degree with the x-axis. Well, do not forget x-axis is the electric field itself. We saw just now E bar is 3 into 10 raised to 3 I cap. So I cap means x-axis. So this is the angle with the electric field. So here we have seen theta is 60 degree. So flux, same formula, E bar dot A bar, which is E A cos theta. And thus phi, electric field 3 into 10 raised to 3, area vector 10 raised to minus 2, and cos 60. Cos 60 you know is half. So this is 30 into half. So flux phi is 15 Newton meter square per Coulomb. This is numerical 15. Based on this idea, there is numerical number 16. What is the net flux? They've asked us flux to the uniform electric field of X size 15. So electric field E bar again, 3 into 10 raised to 3 I cap, and through a cube of side 20 centimeter, oriented so that its faces are parallel to the coordinate planes. Now this is very, very, very simple. This is the cube, let us say. And do not forget that the electric field, let us say this is the x-axis, this is the y-axis, and this is the z-axis. They have already told us that the electric field is along the x-axis. So this is your electric field. And now we need area vectors. Now if you look at, let us call this face as 1. This is face number 1. What will be the direction of the area vector? This is the direction of the area vector. We'll call it S1 bar. What is the, this is phase 2. The area vector is this. We'll call it S2 bar. This is phase 3, let us say. And this is S3 bar. This is phase 4. This is S4 bar. Well, I have not shown the faces facing you, phase 5. And the phase behind us, that's behind the first phase, that's phase 6. We don't need them. So, now look at this. If you look carefully, you can see that electric field E bar and S1 bar are parallel to each other. E bar and S2 bar are anti-parallel to each other. On the other hand, E bar and S3 bar, E bar and S4 bar, they are all perpendicular to each other. So, when I go to find out the net flux, the idea that I use is that what will be the orientations of the particular faces with the electric field. And this is how I shall look at this. Let me work this out. So, through phase 1, E bar parallel to S1 bar. Now, remember S1, S2, S3, S4, S5, S6 are all equal. So, flux Φ1 is E bar dot S bar, which is ES cos 0, which is ES. This is equation number 1. Through phase 2, E bar anti-parallel to S2 bar. That is, your angle theta is 180 degree. So flux Φ2, E bar dot S2 bar, this is S1 bar, which is ES cos 180, and cos 180 is minus 1. So this is minus ES. And through phases 3, 4, 5 and 6, E bar is perpendicular to S bar. So for your faces 3, 4, 5, 6, angle theta is 90. So Φ3, Φ4, Φ5, and Φ6 are all ES cos 90, which is 0. So the total flux through the whole cube, Φ is Φ1 plus Φ2 plus Φ3. Φ4, Φ5 and Φ6, we'll not forget any side. That is ES minus ES plus 0, 0, 0 and 0. And everybody knows ES minus ES is a big fat 0. So, the total flux passing through the cube is 0. This was numerical number 16. Now, numerical numbers 17 and 18 are different fry altogether. Let us see them. Numerical 17 says that the electric field at the surface of a black box indicates the net outward flux, how much? It is 8 into 10 raised to 3 Newton meter square per coulomb. Two questions. What is the net charge inside the box? They asked us sigma q. Easy peasy Japanesey. By Gauss's law, anybody can do this. Phi is sigma q by epsilon 0. So, but of course, sigma q is phi into epsilon 0. I think you can multiply phi here. And this is epsilon 0. And you can get the answer. You want, I can find out the answer. Nearly 80 or 8 9 is 72. Nearly 72 or nearly 70 into 10 raised to minus 9. That's 7 into 10 raised to minus 8 coulomb. And secondly, the B part. If the net outward flux through the surface of the box was 0, so this is a flux is 0, would you conclude that there were no charges inside the box? Why not? Are there no charges in the box? Question mark. Well, the idea here comes from this sigma q. if the flux is zero, it is following from this idea that sigma q has to be zero. So given, we'll start our argument by Gauss's law, that by Gauss's law, phi is sigma q by epsilon zero. If phi is zero, therefore sigma q has to be zero. But sigma q is net charge, and sigma q is zero means that the net charge enclosed by the surface has to be zero. But it does not mean that there are no charges. For example, if there are plus q and minus q, then what is the net charge? Q minus q, it is zero. So this does not mean that there are no charges inside the box. So if flux is zero, it is not essential that there are no charges. It simply means that sigma q, that is the net charge, has to be zero. This is number 17. And number 18 now. Number 18 is also a wonderful idea based on a little bit of imagination. Numerical 18. Now, this is based on a bit of imagination. It says charge Q, which is 10 microcoulomb, is placed at a distance of 5 centimeter from a plate. You know, there is above the square of 10 centimeter sides. They need to find the flux through the square. Now, there is no way in which we can do this sum. There's no formula available because we would not be able to find the electric field through the entire square. And if you want to use Gauss's law, you have to have an enclosed surface. Now, there is no enclosed surface. This is just a simple cube, just simple square rather. This is the square and this is the charge Q. Now, how do I do it? Now, in order to do this, we will have to use a bit of imagination. Let me cover this charge by using 5 such different plates through the, which are connected to this square. So I'm going to do this. I'm going to use 5 plates and I'm going to cover this charge. As you can see, I have used 5 different plates and I have covered this charge. Now this charge has been covered entirely by the cube. So we consider an imaginary cube of 6 faces, each side of 10 centimeter. And now what will be the flux through the cube? By Gauss's law, the electric flux through the whole cube is, can you tell me what it is? I'm sure you know, phi is sigma q by epsilon zero. So let us find out the flux. So flux phi, how much is the charge? 10 micro, and this is 8.85 into 10 raised to minus 12. So you can say nearly 1.2 into 10 raised to 6 Newton meter square per coulomb. But this is not your final answer, because this is the flux through the whole cube and we want to find the flux through each face. So flux, remember there are 6 faces to the cube. So this flux will be divided equally between the 6 faces. So flux through each face, we'll call it phi dash, isn't it 1/6 of the total flux, which is 1.2 into 10 raised to 6 by 6, which is 12 by 6 into 10 raised to 5, which is 2 into 10 raised to 5 Newton meter square per coulomb. This, ladies and gentlemen, is the final answer for numerical 18. Now, the numericals are over. Let us look at the illustration. Now, let me tell you, the numericals were easy, but the illustration is a bit dangerous. If you are not looking into the illustration, you might miss the idea of the illustration. So illustration 11 is on page number 35 of the textbook. I'll draw the diagram for you if you want. They tell me there is this Cartesian coordinate system, and there is a cube. We'll draw the cube in blue, and it is something like this. Pen sometimes does not work. And lovely cube here. And what do the each side is A, and where is the electric field? They are telling me that the electric field, they have also given me the area vectors here. Thank you so much for giving us the area vectors. They call it NR cap and NL cap. Well, these are not area vectors, they're just drawn perpendiculars, nothing else. So they are giving me the electric field also. They tell me that electric field EX is alpha X raised to half. Also EY is EZ is zero. Now, this is the whole idea, that electric field is only along the x-axis. This is electric field. The electric field along y and z directions is zero. Let me write the coordinates also. This is x, this is y, this is z. I forgot that. So if you look carefully, we saw this sometime back in a numerical wherein there was a cube. So only through face 1 and through face 2 will electric flux be linked, because through all the other faces electric field and area vector, let me draw one for your satisfaction. This is S3 bar rather. So S3 bar, S4 bar, they are all perpendicular to E bar. So there is no flux through the other faces. So my first statement is there is no flux through faces 3, 4, 5 and 6. Let me also write the reason. Since E bar is perpendicular to S bar, so flux 3, 4, 5 and 6 is 0. We are only looking at flux through faces 1 and 2. Now also, this is 0 and this A is A. So now at face, let's first find out through face 2. For face 2, look at face 2. Face 2 is at a distance of A. Here X is equal to A. So what is the electric field? Electric field E, they say, is alpha into X raised to half. Now alpha, they have given me 0.1. No, that is A, which is 0.1. Alpha is 800. So 800 into X, that is A raised to half. Now area vector, look at the area vector. Area A bar is, can you see it is in the opposite direction of electric field? So opposite direction of the electric field, area is A square, everybody knows that. But if it is opposite to electric field, then it will be minus I cap. This is entire I cap. So what will be the flux? The flux phi 2, we'll call it E2 bar dot S2 bar. E2 bar is 800 into A raised to half I cap done to A square I cap. Wow. So you can see I cap dot I cap is 1. So this is 800. No, it is minus I cap, right? Yeah. So minus. Let us look at it again. Yeah, minus I cap. So minus 800 into A raised to half plus 2. That's 5 by 2. This is your flux 2. Through phase 1. Let us look at phase 1. How far is phase 1 from the origin? A plus A, that's 2A. So here X is 2A. So electric field E bar, well, it is in the I direction. So that's alpha X raised to half that is 800 into 2a raised to half, that is I cap. And area vector, if we look at the area vector, can you see it is pointing in the x direction? Area is a square, but of course, so s bar is a square, this e1 bar, this s1 bar, I cap. So flux phi 1 is e1 bar dot s1 bar. How much is e1 bar, gentlemen? 800 into 2a raised to half. This is I cap. The whole into a square I cap. So my god, I cap dot I cap 1 again. 800. And let us take 2 raised to half outside. And a raised to half into a square. That's again a raised to 5 by 2. So wow, this is phi 1. Thus, the total flux, we'll add all. And what would be the total flux? Phi. Now phi 3, phi 4, phi 5, phi 6 do not exist. So this is phi 1 plus phi 2. Phi 1 is 800 into 2 raised to half into a raised to 5 by 2. And phi 2 is minus 800. Do not forget, people, into a raised to 5 by 2. So I'm taking 800 common. A raised to 5 by 2 is also common. And 2 raised to half means root 2. Root 2 minus 1. Now, A, they have told me, they have given me A to be 0.1. So flux phi is 800 into 0.1 raised to 5 by 2. And root 2 is 1.4 minus 1. 1.4 minus 1 is 0.4. And 0.1 raised to 5 by 2. So 0.1 raised to 5 by 2. That's 1 by 10. And 1 by 10 raised to 5 by 2. Let us take 5 outside and this raised to half. So 800 into 4. 8 4s are 32. So this is 320. Into. Now, the square root of 10 you can find, that's around 3.2 or 3.3. And you can raise it to 5. And by this idea, you can find out the flux. You can multiply and calculate. It's nearly 1.05 or 1.1 Newton meter square per coulomb. There is a second question also, that find the charge within the cube. Well, Gauss's law comes to our rescue. So by Gauss's law, this is as easy as anything can be easy. Phi into epsilon 0. And so that flux 1.05 or something like that into 8.85 into 10 raised to minus 12. That's nearly 9.3 into 10 raised to minus 12 coulomb. So this is numeric illustration 11 for you. Well, illustration 12 is a very, very beautiful illustration. I think we saw something like this when we did electric flux. If you look at the video for electric flux, you might find something in that area. So let me do this again. There is a cylinder. We called it a dhol-shaped Gaussian surface. So ye ek dhol-shaped Gaussian surface. And this is my coordinate system. This is Y. This is X. And they tell me that the electric field is along. Here it is along this direction. This is E bar. And here it is along this direction. This is E bar again. So they want us to find. They have told me E bar is minus 200 I cap Newton per coulomb for X less than 0. And 200 I cap Newton per coulomb for X greater than 0. We need to find this circular cylinder. Length is 20 centimeter. And radius is 5 centimeter. They want us to find the flux through the surface. Well, it is lovely. first things first, I call this surface 1, I call this surface 2, and I call this surface 3. If I look at surface 1, area vector is in this direction, we call it S1 bar. For surface 2, area vector is in this direction, S2 bar. And for surface 3, this is S3 bar. So, for surface 3, phase 3, E bar and S3 bar are perpendicular. Well, everybody watching this knows that the flux phi is E bar dot S3 bar, which is E S3 cos 90, and cos 90 is 0. Now, if you look at phase 1, can you see S1 bar and E bar are parallel? So, for phase 1, E bar parallel to S1 bar. So flux phi 1 is E S1 cos 0, which is E S1. So E is how much? They tell me E is 200. So that's 200. And the area, the face area is pi r square. Everybody knows that. So that's pi into radius. That's 5 centimeter, 5 into 10 raised to minus 2 whole square. That comes out to be nearly 1.57 Newton meter square per coulomb. This is phi 1. And for phase 2, well, dramatically, if you look at phase 2, you can see E bar and S2 bar again are parallel to each other. So here E1 bar and S1 bar were parallel. Here also they are parallel because electric field at both points is different. So E bar parallel to S2 bar. So again, with the same conviction, ES2 cos 0 is ES, again pi r square, that's again 1.57. And so, total flux phi is phi 1 plus phi 2 plus phi 3. You can add, and finally the flux becomes 3.14 Newton meter square per coulomb. And the second part is the charge. By Gauss's law, phi is sigma q by epsilon 0. So sigma q is phi into epsilon 0. Phi we know is 3.14, and 8.85 into 10 raised to minus 12 gives us 2.78 into 10 raised to minus 11 coulomb. So this is the idea. Thank you so much.